I'm Brandon Horton. I'm 23 years old, and I'm from Richmond, Virginia. I'm going to be America's Next Drag Superstar.
Yes!
My life's... hard. It's weird and not that well understood. There's a lot of hardships, a lot of family problems, a lot of my own problems. Getting hell, I can... so much. Going to 14 schools in 13 years, moving around between my parents and their divorce, and going back and forth because parents think they can do better. It's been hard. I've always been the new kid. Not really... I didn't really start making friends until I was 18. I didn't really start making friends until I started going to the gay club. And I was like, the hell was that on stage? Come find out it's a drag queen. I'm like, what's a drag queen? Look at me now. I started drag April 16th of 2008. I ran Godfrey's Amateur Night, which was the first gay bar I ever went to. Tiffany Deborah was my drag mother. Took me under her wing after my first three wins, and then after my eighth win, I got added to the regular show cast. That was... I was working at Godfrey's. Godfrey's and Babes gave me my first start. I got to do the Trailer Park Trailer Trash Show. That was a lot of fun. I got to just... So to be an amateur competing for something or coming back the following month to just entertain, I was just entertaining. I got a booking. Holy shit. My drag transformation has been insane. I used to be pink and black all in the eye with some eyebrows to here, magenta eyebrows with a different colored lip and a different colored cheek. It was bad. But we all start somewhere. I've transitioned into the edgy girl, the punker, the rocker chick, but I'm still very pretty. I'll put on a gown and I'll look like a woman. but my following is very interesting. I have a huge, wide variety of people in my following. All the way from the fetish bar fallout with my freaks, geeks, and weirdos, to my VCU kids that I fucking love them. I love them. They've supported me the most. All the way to my middle-aged women in short pants with the pinky up because they wear Louis Vuitton. They all support me, and I support all of them. I try my best to remember their names, I try my best to get back to the messages on Facebook, but I love them and they love me. That's it.
It was good until you did that.
Oh, no, I can feel it. You know, are you ready to go to the edge? Alright, last time.
My name's Michelle Levine. Are you ready to go to the edge?
Touchdown in the middle of the city, massive street jam up to Newberry, $1 million party now.
me. I was doing my nails. Yeah. Well, it's time to take you on a tour of my closet. But it's actually not my closet. I packed up as much shit as I possibly could in practice for RuPaul's Drag Race, and I shoved all my shit in 4 suitcases, a plastic bag, a black bag, and a tote. I hope I can bring that much to the show. Well, let's check some shit out. Most of all here, there's a lot of my costumes I have over here that I didn't already show you in the video. Made them myself. I have a blue sequin gown. I have a pants with a jacket for Gwen Stefani. We have a cute little fun sequin outfit, purple dress. This is a vintage outfit from my friend's mom. She wore this in high school. This is real leather. It's fantastic. I like to wear it for Robin or to walk around and be a whore. This is also... Oh, girl, I can't believe I bought this. I got this from Goodwill, and I couldn't pass it the hell up. It's the ugliest dress, so it means it's obviously sickening. We have pants I've cut up, I've been love, my see-through lace, because I'm a whore. See-through leotard, because I'm a whore. I have a cute little witch outfit for Gwen Stefani. And we gotta have my mom's motorcycle jacket. Of course I jacked that shit from her. She knows I have it now. This is a really fun outfit I just recently made. It has a cute little bow tie that goes around the neck, and I tie it real good. And it's super cute, vintage, very twiggy with a pair of sunglasses. Let's see. This was my sister's 8th grade dance dress that she's now given me. Still rock it out. It's fantastic. Over here, I have some shoes, some heels, some shoes. They're there. That's the suitcase I brought them all in. If you look under here, here's all of my hair I brought. Let's check out some hair. We have Gaga, we have short, we have fluffy, curly. This is very neon hitch. Here's more costumes, a Gaga costume, corsets, a dress, some cut-off shorts, more Gaga, a belt, a leotard. Oh, look at this jacket. I really like to embellish and be funky and edgy and punky. It needs to be uneven, not symmetrical. Yeah. And I got, look, lace front, fluffy, lace front, 2 wigs. They're just fun little jabbers, walky things. It's got some brown hair. I have a lot of crap. It's a lot of crap. It's a lot of unorganized crap. But if you ask me where it is, I probably can find it anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes. I can find it for you. I would love to take you to my storage unit and show you the rest of my closet, but the bill was due on the 5th, and today's the 8th, so I can't show you, because I didn't pay it yet, and I can't get in. So I hope this is close for you. This is just, I'd probably say it's about a 1/5 of all my drag. I have a lot of fun, funky pieces. I have a lot of the bigger pieces that I want to show you in my video, but I can't get them out. But I'm very constructively creative. Like, here's a purse. And it's actually a shoebox cut down. It's the lid with the bottom made into a clutch.
No.
You don't say. Welcome back to the Snatch Game, everyone. Bon Quiqui, are you ready for your next question?
Oh, you know I am, sir.
I bet you are. The question is, Hungry Hannah, so hungry, the only thing that fills her up is a 10-inch blank.
The only thing that fills her up, sir, is an imaginary sandwich, because I ain't make her nothing. I'm on break. Next!
Oh. Bon Quiqui is on break, everyone. Can't get to her. All right, your next question. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
All right. Your next question. Psychic Sally is so slutty. Instead of reading your palm, she reads your blank.
Oh, she reads my nothing. Because she come too close to me, I will cut her. She come next to me, that Voodoo Magic, which is the new single I just put out. It's called Cut You, available on iTunes.
Whoa there. Don't get too close. Don't want to get cut. Again, that's not a match, but... Thank you so much for playing, Bon Quiqui. You've been a great sport.
No, thank you, sir.
Don't forget, I'm a cut you.
I'm a cut you on iTunes. Bon Quiqui.
Thank you guys for tuning in. Have a good night.
You want to know what drag means to me? I'll tell you. Because, well, I have to. I love drag. It's a passion that is indescribable. I actually can't tell you what it means to me. I wish I could have other people testify. Jesus. I wish they could testify. I wish you could hear what the audience has to hear. I wish you could hear what people have to say about me that saw me for just one time. And people that have seen me for couples of years. You would know why you want me, because of what they would say. I'm different. I'm crazy. I'm weird. I don't fit a mold. I don't want to be a mold. I want to be a leader of where drag goes. I don't want to be the leader, because if you're the leader, then it goes in the wrong direction. I want to be a leader. I want to be there with Sharon and Raja and Bibi and Tyra. I want to be there with them, and I want all of us to mold drag into something phenomenal that we all can participate in. We all can love. There. I didn't even tell you what drag means to me, but the way I just described whatever the fuck I just described, you get it. I love drag. So much. That's enough.
That's it!